Several weeks ago, we posted a charging compatibility test video of the vivo X90 Pro. It comes with a 120W flash charge charger. And today we got this charger and we'll take it apart. The 120W is clearly printed on glossy white plastic, and the upper port is a single USB-C. All specs info is printed on the opposite side, but it is V12060L1B0. It supports input of 100-240V, 50 or 60s, 3A. And the upper power can be up to 120W, but it only supports 65W PD protocol. To reach a smaller size, the prongs cannot be folded. The size of this charger is about 61x52x29mm. Compared with the Apple 140W charger, the size is almost half of it. The weight is about 137 grams. The charger lab power ZKM003C shows it supports vivo flash charge, QC 2.0, PD 3.0, PPS, QC5, and DCP protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. Next, pry along the gap and remove the plastic case of the input side. We found it cannot be pulled out, so we have to use the cutting machine to cut it off. Two input prongs are connected to the main PCB through black and red wires. All gaps between components are filled with potting compound for fixing and heat dissipation. Flipped to the back, it's pasted with a black isolation plate and heatsink. Then let's clean up the PCBA module. After cleaning it up, we found the planar transformer is placed in the hollow of the PCB to reduce the overall thickness, and it adopts ZVS flyback topology. The protocol chip controls the upper voltage through an optocoupler to achieve a wide range output. Next, we're going to introduce all components inside. Start from the input end. The input time delay fuse is from WalterFuse, 3.15A, 250 volts. The first common mode choke is just next to the fuse. Those two NTC thermistors are used to suppress the inrush current. The safety X2 capacitor is from SDE, 0.22 microfarad. The second common mode choke is larger than the first one and is next to the safety X2 capacitor. Those two bridge rectifiers are from Yangjie. They are connected in parallel to form a half bridge circuit and dissipate heat evenly, 3A, 1000 volts. There are 5 electrolytic capacitors in total. Two larger capacitors are from TEAPO, 27 microfarad, 400 volts for each. The other 3 smaller capacitors are also from TEAPO, 18 microfarad, 400 volts for each. 108 microfarad in total. The differential mode choke is placed in the middle of those capacitors. The mass controller is from Dialog, IW9802. It can be adapted to different working modes, such as ZBS. And it also provides high power density and high output accuracy when working with a secondary side controller. The GaN FET is from Innoscience, a customized model, is qualified to JEDEC standard and supports ESD protection, 650 volts, 260 milliohm. The secondary synchronous rectification controller is from MPS and can support multiple working modes. The maximum operating frequency is 600 kHz. The synchronous rectifier is from AOS and adopts DFN 5x6 package. Those 3 Y capacitors are from ISND, which are connected in series. The optocoupler is above the planar transformer, which regulates the upper voltage. Those 2 solid capacitors for upper filtering are from Beryl. They are connected in parallel, 560 microfarad, 25 volts. The protocol chip is soldered on an independent PCB from Richtek. The upper VBUS MOSFET is from Vergiga Semi and adopts PDFN 3333 package, 30 volts, 3 milliohm. And the USB-C connector is fixed on the other side of the protocol chip. Well, that's all components of this 120W flash charge charger from Vivo. It can not only support Vivo's proprietary protocol, but also support up to 65W PD protocol. After taking it apart, we found that it adopts a planar transformer and GaN FET inside, which is the critical component to make it compact. The GaN FET is from Innoscience, is a customized model for this charger with high quality. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!